everyone, welcome back to another video. Today's video is a updated review on the Movie Heroes Wave 2 Queen Amidala. I first reviewed this figure when I got her, but that was with the webcam, and I don't like using my webcam unless I absolutely have to. And I know Septeria Aviora requested me to do a updated review on the Sandstorm Princess Leia, but I already did a review on the Slave Leia from the Vintage Collection. So I don't like doing videos of the same character in a row, so I decided to do a review, updated review on this figure. And if you have any more updated review requests or any requests at all, just let me know. So before anything, of course, we take a look at the packaging. I don't have this Padme carded. I need it though. Usually when I do a Padme review, I usually have the figure carded and loose, but unfortunately I don't have all the figures carded yet. But she does come on the basic Darth Maul Movie Heroes card, just basic. On the back is a nice picture of her and Qui-Gon, a description about it. You can pause and read what the figure does, and a nice picture of the figure. Information about the battle game card. The other figures in the wave are Darth Maul, Qui-Gon, Jar Jar Binks, and Anakin. And also comes with Obi-Wan too in the wave. I do need Anakin, then I will have all the figures loose in the wave, and I need a carded Padme. So, Padme's articulation is a ball-jointed head, swivel in the shoulders, swivel in the elbows, swivel in the waist, and swivel in the hips. So, good articulation. They could have added ball hinge knees, but I'm not complaining. I'll just give you a 360 here of the figure. I like the texturing on her gown, her battle dress. It feels very nice texture, and her sleeves as well. I do like the hair detail as well. I think it's really nice. I think the face sculpt, it does look like Natalie Portman to somewhat, but she does not look 14 years old or even 16 years old for that matter of fact. She looks like 20s, maybe 30s. So I think Hasbro could have done a better job on the face sculpt, in my opinion. It's not the best. But I like the detail, this little detail on her belt. Her accessories include, of course, the battle die, the battle game card, which I do like this battle game card. A nice picture of Padme right there. Then on the back are her stats, where another nice picture of Padme is. She also does come with one of these things which are in the packaging. I like to keep them. They're cool little profile things. And she comes with a blaster. She doesn't come with a pistol. She comes with a blaster, which can fit into her hand. And she also does come with a base, but I think her base was tan, not silver. I just got a silver one for the review. So pretty nice. And she also does come with a zip line, which you plug into the back of her. There is a hole you can plug into the back of her. And then you can take the blaster. It's a blaster, and you can put it in. This, I think they added this because when it's supposed to be when the scene when Padme, Captain Panaka, and the Royal Guards scale up the building with the zip lines. So that's pretty. It's cool, but if you're going to use this for dioramas, I wouldn't use this one. I would use this one because it's more. The zip line is more accurate to the movie. This is how it looked more. So, yeah. I like it. I don't display it with the zip line anymore. I used to. So yeah, it's nice, but I just don't like the big backpack in her back. If you didn't know, the battle dress is one of my favorite Padme outfits in episode 1. I just think it's really nice. So here is a comparison with the episode 1, a first original 1999 battle dress Padme. I think this the Movie Heroes one is a good update version, but I do think the face sculpt on the 99 one is better. It looks more like Natalie Portman and how it should look. But the texturing on the Movie Heroes one is better, and it looks better. So the only thing I think better about this figure is the face sculpt. Definitely, I'm sure she, I don't know if she's got easier to find. I do need a carded one. If I do ever see her, I'll get her. But I do recommend her. She's a good one. If you like, I know a lot of people like action scenes. This is probably a good action-packed Padme. Even though she doesn't have articulation in the knees, it's still a good one in my opinion. So yeah, so this was a review on the Movie Heroes, Queen Amidala. Thanks for watching. I'll try to do a few more videos today. Depends how the lighting is. It's not that great in here at night. So thanks for watching. Please subscribe to my channel. And as always, may the force be with you. Bye.